100 years have come and gone, it's good to point out the mistakes that we've made, what we did to these minorities, the anti-Semitism that's still going on in this country, anti-black, anti-immigrants, anti-women, and the near genocide of the Aboriginals of America.
His capacity to represent the underdog and engage with the other goes partly to the ballad tradition, but it falls in with the Christian world picture too. He was ahead of his time. The tragedy of Native America and its obliteration by white people is not particularly welcome in this country. Nobody wants to hear about it.
American audiences were totally unfamiliar with Native American anything. Indigenous resistance goes back 500 years. Every now and then, somebody else will come along and champion the things that indigenous people are longing for and protesting for. I liked the gesture, having at least tried with bitter tears.
But on the Seneca Reservation, there is much sadness now. Washington's treaty has been broken, and there is no hope, no how. All across the Allegheny River, they're throwing up a dam. It will flood the Indian country. A proud day for Uncle Sam. But it broke that ancient treaty with a politician's grin. It will drown the Indian graveyards. Corn planter, can you swim? Earth is mother to the Seneca. So they're trampling sacred ground. Change the mint green earth to black mud flats as honor hobbles down.
He was doing stuff that nobody cared to do it or were afraid to do it. He was getting real resistance from radio.
The radio stations didn't want to play it because it demands to be looked at further.
It was a very hard play around the country. John realized that at some point and took out a full-page ad in Billboard magazine and chastised the disc jockeys and called them gutless.
It was quite progressive. Johnny had an open musical mind. He was very close to a folk musician, certainly as close as he was as to a country musician, without being necessarily any of those things.